clinical picture of carcinoma of the breast. When the patient with carcinoma of the breast comes to your clinic, first of all, calling your attention the high risk group, characteristic incidence, female above 50 with previous history of mammary or extramammary carcinoma, family history in this female, female with early menarche, chelate menopause, therefore incidence and the high risk group is very important. The early symptom usually the patient in the bathroom and during bathing, the patient accidentally discovered painless lump in the breast. This is the commonest presentation in MCQ. Painless accidentally discovered lump. And this usually and very common in the bathroom during bathing and palpating the breast. The patient, what is this? Discovered painless, accidentally discovered lump. Trauma may call the attention of the patient to the already present disease. Any trauma, and the patient palpate her breast, find the accidentally discovered lump. For the Arabic student, واحد ست مثلا تخش لك في عيادتك تقول لك الله يخرب بيته، فتقول لها مين يا ست؟ تقول لك جوزي الله يخرب بيته ضربني حته الدين علقه، بعديها بحسس لقيت الورم طلع لي. طبعا تقول لها اشكري جوزك العرباجي قليل الادب ده اللي ضربك، لانه اول مره يعني هيفيد، لان طبعا ما يزعلش مراته غير واحد عرباجي وقليل الادب يعني. ان التروما دي هي اللي كولينج ذا اتنشن بتاعك للسرطان، وممكن يكون كولينج الاتنشن بتاعك بدري، وده هيفيدك باذن الله. Also many patients coming to our clinic complaining of breaking pain in the breast. Tumor during invasion start to infiltrate the nerve endings in the breast and the nerve fibers in the breast, leading to breaking pain. Or this patient also in the bathroom, when he look to the mirror in the bathroom, find what is this recent changes in the size, level or shape of the breast in comparison to the other normal breast. Or the patient may discover recent changes in the nipple or areola or the surrounding skin, like dimpling, puckering, etc. Also, the patient may notice in her underwear, what is this nipple discharge, which usually blood, but maybe also necrotic discharge or even pus. Many of the patient discovered accidentally in the screening program during screening mammography, which is performed usually nowadays for all high-risk asymptomatic women. The patient is asymptomatic, go to the screening program during screening mammography, discovering abnormal microcalcification without complaining of the patient. Therefore, the malignancy may be discovered accidentally. These are the earliest complaint of the patient. Early symptoms, painless accidental discovered lump, breaking beam in the breast, recent changes in the mirror in the size, level, or shape, recent changes in the skin, nipple, or areola, and nipple discharge, or during screening program. Late symptoms are actually symptoms of metastases. The patient may discover swellings, lump in the axilla or supraclavicular region, or arm edema, actually due to lymphatic metastases in the axilla and obstruction of lymphatics draining the arm. The patient also may complaining of bony pain, bony swelling, or pathological fracture. For the Arabic student, fracture without trauma. عظمة كسرت وحدها. تقوم منهم كده تلاقي عظم مكسور. This is evidence of pathology in the bone leading to weakening of the bone and spontaneous fracture. This is called pathological fracture. The patient may complain of chest pain, cough, hemoptysis, dyspnea in case of lung metastasis. The patient may complain of pain in the right hypochondrium, swelling in the right hypochondrium with jaundice in case of liver metastasis. There may be headache, vomiting, blurring of vision due to increased intracranial tension in case of brain metastasis. Also, the metastasis may compress important motor and sensory or sensory area, leading to motor or sensory manifestation. Mental confusion and coma in advanced brain metastases. These are late symptoms of distal metastases and can be mentioned in any malignant tumor in our curriculum. Examination or signs of carcinoma of the breast. When you examine a patient with cancer breast, first of all, general examination, you should examine all the patient from her hair to the little toe for evidence of distal metastases. Locally. Locally, I will explain this like a clinical case. In any clinical case, you should examine the breast bilaterally and the axilla bilaterally, because carcinoma in one breast may lead to malignancy in the other breast and the other axilla. Therefore, the examination should be bilateral axilla bilateral breast, starting as usual with the normal breast. And always remember this patient. In any clinical case, we look first to the breast as a whole. As a whole, we may discover in this breast what? Recent changes in the size of the breast. We all know that 75% are not otherwise specified carcinoma, which is carcinoma with extensive fibrosis. And always remember 75%, because 75% are the commonest malignancy, which is not otherwise specified carcinoma, leading to all this clinical manifestation. And 75% of lymphatics of the breast pass laterally to the axilla. Tumor with extensive fibrosis, when you look to the breast as a whole, you will discover small, shrunken, atrophic breast. But sure, if the breast has no extensive fibrosis, in the rare types, the breast may be enlarged, as in inflammatory carcinoma. Also, the level of the breast. The breast is elevated in comparison to the normal. The breast may be elevated, deformed, displaced, puckered. all these manifestations in the breast as a whole and the changes in size may become very prominent if you ask the patient to elevate the arm above the level of the head. Why? Because when you elevate the arm, you elevate the clavicle. Attached to the clavicle is the pectoral fascia. Therefore, elevation of the arm elevates the clavicle, elevates the pectoral fascia, leading to traction on the Cooper's ligament. Traction in the Cooper's ligament will show traction on the skin. Abnormalities become more prominent in the skin. Changes in the size or level or shape of the breast becomes more and more prominent. Also, if you ask the patient to lean forward, the patient normal breast protrude freely. But if there is tumor with extensive fibrosis, the breast does not protrude like the normal, and deficiency in protrusion of the breast becomes prominent and show evidence of extensive fibrosis in the breast, which may be carcinoma. In addition to the breast as a whole, look to the 3 points nipple, areola, and skin. The nipple may be retracted or show discharge. Therefore, recent unilateral retraction of the nipple, evidence of pathology with fibrosis in the breast, and should be differentiated from congenital retracted nipple, which occurs since birth. This girl and this woman never see a nipple. There is no nipple from the start. Congenital, from since birth, no nipple. And bilateral, while recent unilateral retracted nipple is pathology with extensive fibrosis, reduced traction on the lactiferous duct, leading to nipple retraction. Or male directed nipple. Look for this retracted nipple and this patient. Compare. This is a normal direction of the nipple, which directed downward, forward, and laterally, while this nipple is male directed. Look forward. Also squeeze the nipple. Squeeze the nipple for this. What is this? Nipple discharge. Look to the skin. Look to the skin for this, which becomes more prominent on elevation of the arm. Dimpling. Because elevation of the arm, as we said before, elevates the clavicle, traction on the pectoral fascia, leading to traction on the Cooper's ligament. Therefore, dimpling, which may not appear when the patient put her arm beside the body, the dimpling does not appear, but elevation leading to more and more prominence of the dimpling and the skin changes. Also, the skin may show inflammatory manifestations like inflammatory carcinoma, or what is this? Or show malignant nodules. Or podorange, redness, cancer in cuirass, ulceration, other skin manifestation of carcinoma as before. Never forget eczema. There may be malignant eczema in the nipple and the areola and surrounding skin, and should be differentiated to this malignant eczema from the ordinary common eczema in lactating females. During examination, you may palpate the commonest presentation of cancer breast, which is breast lump. Breastlump usually appear hard, stony hard, irregular, with restricted motility, fixed to the surrounding breast tissue, maybe fixed to the skin, maybe fixed to navel, areola, surrounding structure, muscles, etc. You should examine the axillary lymph nodes, infra and supraclavicular lymph nodes bilaterally. When you palpate the axillary lymph nodes, if you discover in this patient, first, painless, hard, discrete, means separate, mobile lymph nodes, these are early lymph node metastases, painless, hard, discrete, mobile. But in late cases, the malignant lymph nodes attached together becomes matted. Matted means like this, like the metacarbophalangeal joint, matted, attached together. Matted, attached together, but can be counted. You can count four lymph nodes are matted together. Fixed to a surrounding structure and painful in advanced cases. This is the symptoms and the signs of breast cancer. Thank you for good listening and good luck.